Thank you. gentlemen, if you would bow your heads and join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this momentous occasion in which with you we share our accomplishments, especially tonight as we achieve one more goal, our high school diploma. However, we could not have succeeded without the continuous support of our families, teachers, and administrators. We thank you, Lord, for these great individuals that have guided us through this journey. We thank you for the gifts of knowledge, wisdom, and courage that have helped us realize our goals. Lastly, Father, we thank you for all the blessings that you so freely give us and for the inspiration for us to achieve our dreams. In your name we pray, amen.
Please be seated. Good evening. My name is Jenny Weaver, and I am president of the senior class at Ross S. Sterling High School. Parents, extended family, faculty, administrators, and friends, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the graduation ceremonies of the class of 2001. We began our journey 4 short years ago. Never did I imagine the past 4 years would go by so quickly. As an incoming freshman, I was 5 foot tall and extremely nervous. Who could forget the joys of being a freshman? We were sold elevator keys that didn't work, and we got D-hall slips for being late because we were given the wrong direction and ended up in the wrong side of the building. But it was also the beginning of many new adventures. Our first high school football game, our first homecoming, our first year of survival. As sophomores, we did gain some knowledge. We learned not to trust the upperclassmen, but maybe we weren't quite as knowledgeable as we thought. Our sophomore class definitely had the most school spirit, but the upperclassmen once again got the last laugh when we held up our sign at the pep rally and we had misspelled sophomores. Yes, there are 3 O's in sophomore. By the time we were juniors, we had found our niche. We were just 1 year away from seniority. And thanks to our football team that year, we had the privilege of singing "The Night We Drove Old Dixie Down." That was a great feeling. Our senior year was finally here. Our last high school football game, our last high school homecoming, senior research papers, chicken fry, and our prom. Wow, was that a memorable night for some of us. Our dates had a ball game and didn't get to prom until 11:45, just in time for pictures and one dance. That's what we get for taking those boys from across town, right, Brian? And who could forget how cute Nolan looked at the beach with all his little twisties in his hair? 4 years later, I am still only 5 foot tall, and although I didn't gain much in size, I have gained memories and friendships that will last a lifetime. Thanks to JoJo, Chris, Katie, and Ryan for all the piggyback rides when the walk was just too long or the stairs were just too steep for me. You never let me get left behind. Thank you to all our teachers for believing in us and helping us to grow into the individuals we have become today. To Ms. Tyner, Ms. Carr, Mr. Taylor, and Mr. Sanifer, thanks for being there for us and keeping us on the right track, even as difficult as it got at times. And of course, thank you to our parents and guardians, for without you and your support, we wouldn't be standing here today. Some say we were definitely a class of waiting to happen, but I like to think we were a class filled with individuality, determination, spirit, and definitely a class with minds of our own. Now it's time to take the knowledge we have gained and move on to the next milestone in our lives. My next adventure will take me to the University of Texas. My best friend, Jesse, is going to attend a school 1,500 miles away, but after 14 years of friendship, she knows she will always be right there with me in my heart and thoughts. To my classmates, I want to say thank you for the honor of serving as our class president. We have been blessed as a class. Each of us is unique and has brought us something special to our group. This class would not be the same without each and every one of us. I wish each of you success and happiness in all that you attempt as we move on to the next chapter in our lives. As graduating seniors, we all have our own ambitions, our own dreams to pursue. But whatever our separate pathways may take us, we will always be the class of 2001 from Rossess Sterling High School.
As we're about to venture off into 507 different routes to success, we look back and reflect on the countless memories that brought us here. Each one of us has become a piece of a puzzle that together paints a picture of the past 4 years. Whether memories happy or sad, we have survived it all. We have been given a challenge and proved to all that we are a class like no other. During the last 4 years, we can reflect on memories of our first love, our first car, and our first party. We can all remember the 2001 elections and how screwed up our political system really is, and the impeachment trials of former President Bill Clinton and his famous quote, "I did not have sexual relations with that woman." We all share memories of getting rowdy at sporting events and cheering our Rangers to victory. We can remember Lee Week and how our parents did all the work. We can remember our relationship problems and the gaining the acceptance of parents. We can remember our class leaders from Student Council, Key Club, and National Honor Society. And certainly, we remember and will never forget senior activities such as prom, senior party, and chicken fry. I think that we all agree that we've become a family that has always offered a shoulder to lean on. We can all agree that our time here at Sterling has been phenomenal. Personally, if I had to do it all again, I wouldn't. But it was nice while it lasted. To the Rossess Sterling graduation class of 2001, I want you to sit back and relax and reflect on the past 4 years.
We can all look back and remember walking down the big blue hallway for the first time. Those hallways were where student life began.
We cautiously walked in, never without a friend close by our side. It was scary because we were freshmen, so everything was new to us.
Then came this year. We proudly walked in, still with friends, but not so carefully bound to them. We were the top dog and glad to meet the challenges before us.
Events such as Lee Week left us with memories of school spirit and pride. I would have to speak for us all when I say it allowed us to come together as a class to declare war against our inferior rival, Robert E. Lee.
We will never forget football season's parties and how Jenny Weaver couldn't go to one without crying.
It is strange to think how a train could be so inviting to guys when it's speeding down the tracks. Isn't that right, Chris and Austin?
We will always remember when those unnamed sophomores painted Lee's Rock and how somehow the letters RSS ended up all over their letters, bleachers in blue.
We may not have won the game that year, but I think our pranks topped theirs.
Remember the time that the football players collected money for a barbecue after the last game at Chris Clement's house?
After they got caught, they could have been seen regularly at a local Coinstar machine.
Remember homecoming when Jason Devport got written up for freaking during the presentation of the homecoming court?
Remember how good all those sports did this year? Baseball and volleyball went to playoffs, and water polo and girls basketball went to state.
Yeah, and we almost beat Lee this year.
Don't forget how choir got straight sweepstakes at UIL contest, and how the band and stars got into region for marching contest.
Then the stars won sweepstakes and the judges award at both of the contests they went to in the spring.
We can remember having pep rallies and watching the stars dance and how well they did on their famous step routine.
Remember when Ms. Jacobs went talking to the microphone and had no clue what she was saying, so everyone continued their own conversations?
And what about those bleacher creatures and how they showed Ross S. Sterling how to back that thing up?
Remember how certain students always had appointments during lunch?
Candace, where you at?
Remember during spring break on Crystal Beach when all the girls' tops for some reason came off when the cameras rolled by?
Remember all the bomb threats there were during our junior year and how many times we had to sit out in the grass in front of the school? It seemed like the SWAT team was always there.
Then they canceled the student-faculty basketball game because it posed a threat, and I still ain't got my money back.
Remember when Peterson gave Sean a birthday surprise? I think Matt Pohl still might have a picture of David jumping out naked out of Sean's locker.
Remember how even yesterday we had to wear our ID badges to school or we got a detention?
Remember all of the rumors this year?
We can all remember staying up all hours of the night, pimping on the phone, and then sleeping through class the following morning. We can remember fantasizing about that one boy or girl who would never give you a chance. Lucky for us, our dream came true. Is that right, Ellie Beth?
We would get into fights with one another and knew that making up was the best part. And no other than Kirby and Brian, Matt and Misty, and Lauren and Arnold taught us that despite differences, love overcomes all.
We can all remember us gathering in the senior office, talking loud enough for Mr. Taylor to come out of his office, and he would always say, "What are these people doing in my office?" Then he would immediately kick Randy Henry and Trey Conley out because he knew they were supposed to be in class.
Remember when a car backed into Cindy Flores after a football game our sophomore year, and Gabriel and Jason McKee jumped out of the way?
Then all she was worried about was if her polo boots were messed up.
Remember how we were so excited to finally have a job, and then we hated going every day and complained?
Remember how we are all going to be the best drivers when we got our licenses, and then there were about 50 wrecks the first semester we had them?
We definitely were not the best drivers. Remember how Katie Smoke's wheelchair had to be moved out of the senior panoramic picture after her wreck?
Remember the Craig Mutt, Magner, and the Coil Hollow cliques?
The activities we had as seniors brought us together and made us a class. It was the times that we spent out of school that made us most memorable.
Remember how everyone stole each other's cans during the ho-ho-ho scavenger hunt and how the people who won always bought food ahead of time?
My team got second place this year, and it's a good thing that ramen noodles are so cheap.
Remember chicken fry and how we worked all day and just smelled like chicken and grease for days?
Yeah, and how we ate so many of those chocolate chip cookies that there weren't enough to put in the dinners.
Remember how we tied both years at Potter Puff and how penalties for foul language cost the seniors 2 touchdowns worth of yards.
Remember prom and how we looked forward to it for 4 years and then after spending so much money, it was over so fast.
Remember Philip Adams' white flip-flops? Aren't those against dress code? Not to mention Patrick Page and Jared Tucker's pimp tuxes or Stephen King's red hat. And Michael Carlton, you're not Dick Tracy, this was prom.
Remember how all the girls who took Lee baseball players didn't have dates until 11:59, and the people who took pictures had to stay late?
Remember all of those fun times at beach after prom, or do you? And how Emmanuel ran down the beach naked?
Yeah, and I heard if you didn't see that, they have it on video.
Remember the girls who thought they belonged to the Coyote Ugly, so they went and had shirts made?
Remember how many early dismissals we got during EOC testing? Thanks, Ms. Carr.
But I believe, and I think, we can all remember Priest Burrell and how he had such a warm and caring heart. He always had an open ear to all that needed someone to confide in. Some of the people who will never forget from our years here at Sterling are the teachers. They were always there to help and always willing to put in the extra time to help you for the next test. Wasn't it great how some of them understood that sometimes you just had to take a nap during class?
It was great how we had 3-day weekends in economics because Mr. Mullman just doesn't do Mondays. Also how Ms. McReynolds made physics so interesting by showing us that baguettes are the flashiest diamonds to have.
I just want to give a special thank you to Mr. Smith, who has always gave his students love and support. You will surely be remembered.
We will never forget Ms. Black and how she took charge of everything. Through the years, she has at one time sponsored almost every club and organization in the school and still has time for Tuesday night tutoring at her house that can amazingly help your average go from failing to a B.
To Mrs. Taylor and Mrs. Carr, you both have done an excellent job this year. You took us both under your wings, took us all under your wings, and cared for us like we were your very own.
We will never forget the memories that we have made these past 4 years. From 8:30 a.m. on August 14, 1997, when we first bell rang until today, as we sit together side by side before we get our diplomas, we have made and shared experiences that we'll always remember. We have grown up together from being insecure freshmen to confident young men and women. Together, we have mourned the deaths of friends and celebrated the achievements of others. In 5, 10, or 30 years from now, you might not remember the stink bombs that were set off in the commons or when fake poop was put into the Coke machine, but I hope you will be able to look back at this memory and smile. Over the last week or two, we have all listened to several speakers who have given us advice about the rest of our lives. One that sticks out in my mind is the one that told us of how we will probably forget everything that is said in the speeches that are given at graduation. That might be true, and you might not remember this one or the things that Gabe and I have said, but I hope that you do remember this moment because it is the last one you will have of high school. In a few minutes, our names will be called one by one, and we will walk across the stage to receive our diplomas. We will switch our tassels, throw our hats, and after the last notes of pomp and circumstance fade, we may never see each other again. We will say goodbye to friends and wish them good luck in the future. Even if we all go our separate ways and our paths do not cross again, we have shared the class of 2001. After we walk across the stage tonight, we will no longer be boys and girls or called children. We will be young adults. No longer will we be able to rely on our parents for everything. We will have our own choices to make and new challenges to overcome. As one chapter of our lives ends, another begins and a whole new world awaits us. Finally, I would like to share a few words from a man that has influenced us in many ways and has been in our lives since we were very young. He has written many famous books, such as The Cat in the Hat and Green Eggs and Ham. In his book, Oh, the Places You'll Go, he shares with us these words of wisdom. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the guy who'll decide where you go. So, be your name, Boxbam or Bixby or Bray, or Mordecai, Ali, Van Allen, O'Shea, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.
Thank you. Hey, y'all. Over the last few days, while I was deciding what I could say to y'all tonight and trying to somehow include all the advice that I've gotten, I finally reached two conclusions. The first is that I must address those friends, relatives, and teachers in the audience that have made each of us on this field into the people we are. Secondly, I have to try to actually hold the interest of my fellow graduates during the 5 minutes allotted for me to speak. The first task being the simplest, I will address it first. To those parents in the audience, I can only say that although we are not always good at showing it, most of us know that you have our best interest at heart. And deep down, we really do trust and value your judgment. I want to thank each of you, especially my mom and dad, for loving us enough to say yes when you could and no when you had to, and for giving us the strength through difficult situations to get to where we are tonight. As for the teachers, I know that there are far too many of you to mention all that you have done in getting us from a bunch of freshmen to a class of graduating seniors. But I'll name a few of you anyway. To all the math and science teachers in my life, thank you for teaching me to share your passion and for helping to guide and shape my future. And to the English teachers, thanks for tolerating my not always so great attitude and encouraging me anyway. I especially thank Ms. Floyd for agreeing to help me with this speech instead of making me turn in that final project. To everyone who has loved us over the past 12 years and is here tonight to celebrate with us, I can only say that without you, our joy would have been a little less and our fears a little stronger. Now comes the hard part, addressing the class of 2001. What can I share with y'all who are graduating with me tonight? What have I experienced or learned during my 4 years at Sterling that you have not experienced and learned along with me? Since our freshman year, we have grown and learned together as students and as individuals. And who we are tonight reflects who we have been for the past 4 years. Our graduation marks the end of the time that we will have to take eligibility slips around on Wednesdays, or wear ID badges, or get parental permission to leave campus, or hold up our hands to go to the bathroom. But it means the end of more than just these inconveniences. After tonight, there won't be a Miss Black who we can call at all hours of the night to ask about that calculus homework we put off for way too long. There won't be a Miss Pitts who is willing to give up her personal time and sleep to make sure that her orchestra students not only sound good, but also achieve lifelong memories. No one will look over our shoulders to see whether we're keeping up with our obligations, and this is both a blessing and a responsibility. After tonight, some of us will go to college and some of us will go straight to work. All of us, though, will be moving forward to face a new kind of life, armed only with the knowledge that we have accumulated during these past 4 years. In that light, I would like to offer a few words of advice. First, don't worry about the future. Remember that worrying is almost always completely ineffective. The real problems in our lives are likely to be those that hit without warning, that no amount of previous worrying could have helped anyway. Appreciate music. It is the best outlet for emotion that I have ever discovered and a great way to relieve stress. Whether you play it or listen to it, don't ever go an entire day without some kind of music. Right, Dad? Appreciate people. When someone is kind to you, it is always twice as pleasant if you appreciate it instead of assuming that you deserved it. A grateful attitude makes any situation more pleasant for everyone involved. Don't waste time worrying about other people's opinion of you. They will always respect you more anyway if your actions reflect who you really are, not who you think they want you to be. Always read the directions, even if you don't plan on following them. You never know when they might say something important. Know the value of friendship. This means both learning how to have a friend and how to be one. Without true friends, none of us would be here tonight. Learn to accept injustice in life. We are often accused of being a generation of whiners, and to some extent, this is true. Part of maturity is learning to rise above unfairness instead of letting it slow us down. Learn to be self-sufficient. We will go farthest in life by assuming that most problems the less we rely on others, the more we will be able to handle difficult situations, and the more energy will be left over to help those we love. Finally, never give up on a dream. Dreams are what make each of us unique, and they are the only hope we have of a better future. Our dreams represent our highest potential. Only by accomplishing them can we truly achieve our destiny. I would like to close by reading a poem I found called Growing by Brooke Mueller that I believe truly sums up our thoughts and emotions tonight. She writes, "I'm leaving now to slay the foe, fight the battles high and low. I am leaving, hear me go. Please wish me luck today. I've grown my wings, I want to fly. Seize my victories where they lie. I am going, but please don't cry. Just let me find my way. I want to see and touch and hear. Though there are dangers, there are fears. I'll smile my smiles and dry my tears. Please let me speak my say. I'm off to find my world, my dreams. Carve my niche, sew my seams. Remember, as I sail my streams, I'll love you all the way."
Well, it's finally my big speech time. Many people have given me an array of ideas as to exactly how to write this speech. And to them, I say thank you very much. Suggestions came from some of the strangest places and some of the most unlikely people. The majority of conversations I've had lately have all come to the question, have you started your speech yet? And to them, I always said, of course not. I don't plan to start it until May 24th. And that's when it would happen. I call it the suggestion syndrome. Some suggestions have been, you need to write about the crisis of our time and how to solve them. Others would be, you should discuss the lofty ideals of our society and how this generation can achieve them. Some of my favorites would definitely have to have been, you need to try and beat the egg-juggling, hand-puppet-talking, earshot brothers. And some just simply said, please, it's going to be hot and humid. We're all going to be miserable. Just make it short. But then a suggestion came from one of the most unexpected sources that won my attention. All the person said was, don't write about lofty ideals and noble principles, and don't try to be too funny. Just write about what you know. But then I had to decide what I really knew. Sure, I know how to integrate trigonometric functions due to the genius of Miss Black, and I know why a satellite stays in Earth's orbit, or why an inductor resists the change in current flow, thanks to Miss McReynolds up there. And I know that the administrators are very serious when they tell you to only park in legal parking spots in the Sterling parking lot. Thanks to our excellent guards, I might add. But I didn't think I needed to go in depth into any of those aspects of my knowledge tonight. While I was trying to decide what exactly I knew, I was listening to the radio and the perfect song came on. It's a country song called Burn by Jody Messina. Because y'all definitely don't want to hear me sing and I don't have the talent of some of my best friends, I'll read part of the lyrics for you. She asks, do you want to be a poet and write? Do you want to be an actor up in lights? Do you want to be a soldier and fight for love? I'm a mountain and touch the clouds above. She goes on to say, be anyone you want to be. Bring to life your fantasies. But I want something in return. I want you to burn like a candle in my life. In the last 4 years, I've seen a very tiny, tiny, minute tip of that iceberg called life. And from what I've seen so far, I'm not really excited to enter into adulthood. It seems like life becomes a meaningless repetition of work, sleep, and bills. For some reason, the duties of adulthood make you forget all those aspirations and goals you once had. It dawned on me that what I know better than anything else right now are my dreams. I know them like the back of my hand. Given the time, I'd list them all for you. But just to name a few, going to A&M and being a fighting Texas Aggie. Being an aerospace engineer and designing planes that no one ever thought possible. Living in New York, skydiving, again. I could go on, but you get the point. I realize that we need to remember our dreams. Right now, the dreams that we've had for the last 4, 8, or 18 years are finally coming into view. We're about to take true control of our own lives, and we have the power to go out and actually realize our goals. But life happens, and we tend to forget those dreams and aspirations of our youthful high school years. I'm asking you tonight to write your dreams down. Make a list, set it in stone, and don't forget them. If life gets too hectic, set your list down, straighten your life back out, pick your list back up, and keep on living your dreams. Or if you find life getting too monotonous, search through your old stuff, find your old list, and start living those dreams again. It is possible. I make an oath to you tonight that I'm going to diligently seek to attain my goals, and I'm not going to forget them. Will you remember your goals? I was at a conference at A&M this year, and a terrific speaker made the comment that really stuck. He said, there's a race in you that has never been run, and there's a fire in you that has never had the chance to burn. Give yourself the chance to become the best individual you can become. Don't doubt yourself. Each of us are of great worth and have the power to succeed. But as we go on to fulfill our dreams and become awesome people, we cannot forget to thank the people that help us get there, or in our case, here, tonight, graduation. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for allowing us to be here this night, for allowing us the opportunity to live in this free land and partake of this glorious education, and for forgiving us of our shortcomings. Thank you, parents, for supporting us this night and for supporting your children, and especially to my mom, dad, grandparents, aunts, uncles, and family friends. I love you more than words could ever say. And to the teachers, I've been thinking all year how I could possibly convey the depth of my gratitude for what you put up with and endure so that we may have an education. But I couldn't find a better way, excuse me, other than just say thank you from the bottom of my heart. And to the class of 2001, strive to be the best people you can be. Live up to your true potential. And as the first, yes, first graduating class of the new millennium, set an example. Set an example for the next 1,000 graduating classes. In the words Henry David Thoreau spoke so many years ago, go confidently in the direction of your dreams and live the life you've always imagined.
There are many people here tonight that we would like to recognize. We would like to express our appreciation for the job they've done with these young people over the years. First, I'd like to recognize the Board of Education. If you would, please stand, and please wait till all are standing before we recognize these with our applause. Mr. David Havel, President. Mr. Jeb Bush, Vice President. Ms. Felithria Barnes, Secretary. Mr. Weston Cotton, Assistant Secretary. Dr. Clarence Albus and Dr. James Lewis, would you please join me in recognizing the Board of Education? We are also pleased tonight to have with us the members of the Central Office staff and the Westtown support staff. Again, would you please stand and please hold your applause until all are standing. Dr. Jerry Roy, Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Dick Hallam, Dr. Ben Coker, Dr. Barbara Saltis, Dr. Mark Stafford, Mr. Mark Stafford, sorry, Doctor. Mr. Al Weatherall, would you please recognize them at this time? The staff at Ross Sterling High School, Stewart Career Center, School Community Guidance Center, and Alternative Learning Program are made up of men and women who care about your children. They have worked with these young people for 4 years and have grown to love and know these young people. A number of them are sitting in the stands tonight because, like you, they have a senior graduating. With the staff at Ross Sterling High School, Stewart Career Center, School Community Guidance Center, Alternative Learning Program, please stand at this time and be recognized. You, as parents of these young people, have played a vital role in your child's education. We appreciate your support and the support that you have given your child. Would the parents and guardians of a graduating senior please stand at this time? And last but certainly not least, I'm sure there are some proud grandparents out there. So grandparents, would you please stand? Tonight, as we call the name of our graduates, we will point out the various cum laude degrees. Our summa cum laude is the top 2% of the graduating class. The magna cum laude is the next 3%, and the cum laude is the next 5%. These students represent the top 10% of the senior class, and we will recognize their achievement individually as their names are called. You will also notice in your program tonight that we have listed the names of students who have received honors, awards, and scholarships. Because we have recognized them individually at an earlier ceremony, and because their name is in the program tonight and will appear in the Baytown Sun, we will not list them individually. We have made every effort to make sure that their names are in the program, but unfortunately some names were given to us before the program went to print. The scholarships listed in the program represent $1,350,000 that these young people have received. We not only congratulate these fine young people, but we also share the joy for you parents. At this time, Dr. Jerry Roy, Superintendent of Goose Creek Schools, will present the graduating class of 2001.
Before I certify this class of 2001, I want to take just a moment to remember a friend. This past Sunday, Dr. Sandra Northcutt passed away. Dr. Northcutt touched so many lives and many of you in the stands. Dr. Northcutt, a teacher, principal, executive director of elementary schools, would you bow your heads with me and for a moment of silence in remembrance of Dr. Northcutt? Thank you. As superintendent of the Goose Creek Consolidated Independent School District, It is my privilege to certify the class of 2001 of Ross Sterling High School. You have met the curriculum requirements identified by the Goose Creek Board of Trustees and the State Board of Education, and have successfully completed the exit level assessment instrument or an individualized education program. The very fact that you have completed your studies and are part of this audience tonight means that the last 12 years have prepared you to accept the many awesome responsibilities and demands in your new adult world. Certainly, that is the fervent hope of the faculty and staff of Ross S. Sterling High School. As you say farewell to us, you say hello to tomorrow. There should be love and fondness for what you have done, and there should be anticipation and joy for what yet will be. Take what you have learned and use it. Use it at this commencement. Use it as you begin your new life as an equal partner in the world. Use it as you meet challenges. Use it now and throughout your lives. May it serve you well. Luck, success, and happiness to the class of 2001 of Ross S. Sterling High School. Congratulations.
We have now come to that phase of our graduation that we've all been waiting for. We have discussed the meaning of the ceremony with our seniors and would like to mention to our guests and parents, while this is a happy and joyous occasion, this is a ceremony of honor and dignity. We would like to ask you and your cooperation in maintaining this honor and dignity as we call our seniors. The senior counselor, Mr. Eric Sandifer, will be announcing the names for tonight's graduates. Would the first row please stand?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct privilege and very real pleasure to announce the members of the Ranger graduating class of 2001. Martin Acosta. John Adams. Philip Glenn Adams. Alexa Adcock. Mitchum Amab. Juan Aldaco. Robert Treb Alderson. Oscar Aldretti. Natalia Marie Allen. Catherine Allison, cum laude. Sadaf Altoff. Maria Alvarez. Jacqueline Ann Anderson. Mary Elizabeth Anderson. Stephanie Michelle Anderson, magna cum laude. Elibeth Ramirez Andrade. Timothy John Andrews, magna cum laude. Nicole Marie Arsenault. San Juanita Arismendez. Creston Airy. Eloisa Avalos. Vicky Iyer. Jonathan Ayler. Chase Baber. Blake Bassigalopi. Crystal May Ballinger. Hendra Kelsey Baptiste. Rainicia Baptiste. Manuel Barba. Stephen Barney. Colby Bowman. Katie Bean. Holly Beebe. Tiffany Beers. Brittany Bell. Elodia Benitez. Chris Berger. Jonathan Bernard. Nimish Bhakta. Tiffany Ann Beison, summa cum laude. William Robert Black, magna cum laude. Kara Lynn Blackburn. Jeremy Blades. Brandon Blaylock, cum laude. Amber Blogg. Jelani Blunt. Ryan Blystone. Rachel Boaz. Garrett Boyster. Michael Bowen. Kristen Bowie. Kenneth Boyle. Brandon Bradley. Raquel Monique Bradley. Lindsay Bradshaw. Cody Brazel. Jessica Lynn Brigalia. Tanya Brooks. Kolsha Brown. Lindsay Marie Brown, cum laude. Tiana Brown. Nick Bryant. Zakiah Scott Bryant. Jeremy Bulger. Amanda Lynn Burkett. Daniel Priest Burrell. Chris Burt. Adrian Brittany Capitillo. Zulema Cardenas. Valeria Cardiel. Jenny Carlisle, cum laude and three-year graduate. Michael Carlton. Seth Carpenter. Dorinda Carroll. Leandra Lawana Carruthers. Isabel Castellanos, three-year graduate. Joanna Castilleja, summa cum laude. Arnold Cavazos. Yuridia Serrano, three-year graduate. Artie Challenger. Mary Chapa. Andrea Chapman. Anika Charles. Tamika Chase. Robert Chavez. Casey Jeray Cherry. Clayton Schoep. DJ Church. Ashley Victoria Clark. Chris Clement. Jennifer Cobb, cum laude. Amanda K. Cochran. Crystal Codrington. Brian David Cole. Mike Coleman. Clayton Lindsay Conder. Lauren Adrian Conley, cum laude. Trey Connolly. Ashley Joe Conway. Jason Cook. Christine Cooley. Lauren Cooper, cum laude. Maria Cornejo. Alejandro Cortez. Monica Cortez. Nathan Cotton. Adam Coven. Ashley Crawford. Trey Cream. Augustine Cuevas. Crystal Diane Curry. Jason Davenport. Angela Marie Davis. Tyler Davis. Christine Dawson, 3-year graduate. Jay Dawson. Jennifer Deal. Albie De La Garza. Yanira De La Garza. Agatha De Leon, magna cum laude. Lucas Wayne DeLoss. Andrea Dempsey. Isaac D'Souza III. Latrace Chanel Dustin. Brentford Docklin. Crystal Donahue. Sharondra Douglas. Heather Downs. Holly Downs, cum laude. Alicia D. Drinkard. Michael Duhon. Jamie Lynn Dunham. Laura Lee Dunn. Jessica Michelle Durr. Jana Lynn Ernst. Robert Aaron Eaton. Alan Craig Enderly Jr. Olivia Estrada. Ruth Estrada, 3-year graduate. Jennifer Ezel. Ryan Felder. Bonnie Elizabeth Ferguson, summa cum laude. Haley Ferguson, summa cum laude. Kirby Ferguson. Micah Lane Fusey. Rebecca Fleming. Scott Daniel Fleming, cum laude. Cynthia Flores, cum laude. Jesse Flores. Santos Flores. Fallon Fontenelle. Kashana Fontenot. Dustin Foreman. Ryan Elizabeth Fox, magna cum laude. Meredith French. Ashley Futrell. Timothy Galloway, cum laude. Rosalina Galvan. Amadonna Garcia. Amanda Michelle Garcia. Erica Garcia. Fernando Garcia. Hector Garcia Jr. Kristen Marie Garcia. Perla Garcia. Katie Gardner, cum laude. Jonathan Edward Gary. Chad Garten. Linda Garza. Tracy Marsha Gaston. Christopher George. Vern Gerson. Tiffany Gibson. Rachel Eileen Golden, 3-year graduate. Camille Gomez. Alma Gonzalez. Delia Jasmine Gonzalez. Lenny Gonzalez. Luis Gonzalez. Crystal Renee Goodson, magna cum laude. Jenny Gordon. Sheena Michelle Gordon. Donald Graybill. Nicholas Grafton. Lawrence Granger, 3-year graduate. Justin Graves. Sherman Gray, the third. Haley Ray Gregory. Gabriel Leon Griffin. Emmanuel Griffin. Cade Griffin. Charlene Grovell. Emma Grunden. Ashley Gidros. Karina Guzman. John Hafley the third. Joe Haney. Kimberly Ann Hanley, magna cum laude. Delina Crystal Amber Harris, 3-year graduate. Jennifer Harris. Holly Harrison. Summer Siobhan Abair. Jared Heckler. Hannah Elizabeth Hinkey. Randy Henry. Iris Hernandez. Luce Herrera. Cody Harrington. Richard Hippolito Jr. Jenny Hogue. Jessica Lynn Holloman. David Howell. Tiffany Hoyle. Shyla Hudson. Fernella Hippolyte. Jana Elizabeth Ikes, cum laude. George Isaac Jr.
Martha Isis. Marcus Jackson. Brandon Jagnanen. Chase Jagnanen. Vanessa Jaramillo. Susan Jarvis. Stephen Craig Jenkins. Kyle Gentho. Gerardo Jimenez, cum laude. Joshua Johnson. Joseph Jones. Justin Jones. Candace Jordan, magna cum laude. Dave Joseph. Stephen Kang, summa cum laude. George Kessel. Chris Keys. Scott Kinder. Craig King. Katie Kittinger. Matt Kloss. Jason Robert Knight, magna cum laude. Andrew Kohlmeyer. Jessica Lynn Kuhlman, summa cum laude. Marina Lackey. Chanel Lacombe. Christopher Lamarck. Courtney Langham. Lindsay Lanier. Diane Marie Lott. Amy Christine Lee, cum laude. RJ Lemma. Rachel Leonard. Garrett Linderman. Dustin Lindley. Nick Lloyd. Chris Lockridge, cum laude. Carrie Ann Lofgren. Adrian Lopez III. Chris Lopez. David Lopez Jr. Kristen Deanne Lotsbeach. Shelly Lumbreras. Jeremy Markham. Megan Martin. Desiree Martinez. Octavio Martinez, 3-year graduate. Wendy Sue Massa. Uriah Matthew. Jonathan Matthews. Monica Ann Mazock. Jamie Lee McBride. Jamarcus McCarthy. Stephanie McCauley. Natalie Lynn McCoy. Christina McDonald. Crystal McDonald, summa cum laude. Rebecca Lynn McDonald. Jeffrey Allen McGee, magna cum laude. Melissa K. McHugh. Daniel McKee. Brandy Nicole McLemore. Janie McMillan, magna cum laude. Cynthia Lynn McReynolds, summa cum laude. B.J. Williams. Laurie Metter. Juan Pablo Medina. Arisha Meineke. Rhett Mingo. Helen Miles. Ben Miller. Brandy Miller. Talmadge Miller. Marcus Edward Milligan. Cheryl Denise Milner, summa cum laude. Kayla Miner, three-year graduate. Nebby Miner, three-year graduate. Mark Modisette. Hector Molina. Jamie Nicole Monceau. Jerry Moody. Jonathan Mora. Juan Morales Jr. Laura Nicole Morris. Candace Nichelle Mouton. Dustin Moyer. Adam Wesley Mullins. Sergio Munguia Jr. Alfonso Neal II. Crystal Neal. Robert Nelson. Erica Yvette Nichols. Lindsay Nichols, cum laude. Melanie Nichols. Sarah Nolan. Melissa Ray Novosad. Sean O'Banion. Jerry Oden. Laura Oliveris. Jaisal Ornelas. Edna Ozuna. Stephen Cassidy Pace, cum laude. Tasha Pagan. Patrick Page. Gregory Allen Paylett. Susanna Marie Pies. Edwin Palomo. Heath Parker. Carl Parker. Jesse Parrish. Matthew Glenn Parrish. Nikita Patel. Irvi Patel. Marianne Patino. Carmen Pequeño. Doris Perez. Josue Perez. Amanda Perry. Carrie Nicole Perry.
David Peterson, Jarrett Petrosky, Larry Petty Jr., Eric Ferris, Misty Luann Pickens, Deronda Petrie, Matthew Pohl, Austin Powers, Lowell Powers, Gianna Prince, Brian Provost, summa cum laude, Diana Puente, Lauren Blair Purvis, Bernice Quiroga, David Wesley Rabke, Monica Michelle Ramirez, Denora Ramos, Jose Angel Ramos, Julie Lene Rawls, Nikki Reed, Andy Restrepo, Ruben Reyes, Rudy Reyes Jr., Karina Richards, Kyle Richards, Dory Lynn Rido, magna cum laude, Gabby Rincon, Jovan Rios, Carlos Enrique Rivas Jr., Tisha Robiskevich, magna cum laude, Megan Nicole Roberts, Renee Rodriguez Jr., Ricardo Rodriguez Jr., Yuridia Rodriguez, Ryan Rogers, Jose Sagastume, Annabelle Salinas, Edward David Salinas, Kelly Santabria, Maria Sanchez, Melissa Sanchez, Monica Sanchez, Dana Sanders, Patricia Sandoval, Manuel San Miguel III, Jeremy Saunders, Krista Michelle Schnell, Joseph Scott, Amy Marie C., Samantha Segovia, 3-year graduate, Everardo Savine, Ashley Sharp, Brandon Devon Shepherd, Matt Sherman, Brandy Sherry, Amanda Lynn Schimmick, Blanca Silva, 3-year graduate, Ronnie Simmons, Tabitha Simon, Celeste Alexis Singleton. Lee Seipel. Tiffany Alana Small. JC Smalley. Amanda Denise Smith. Ashley Denise Smith, cum laude. David Smith III. Derek Smith, cum laude. Jonathan Paul Smith, cum laude. Kara Marshall Smith. LaBilvia Smith. Megan Denise Smith. Patience Smith. Robin Smith. Shanavia Smith. Crystal Smithson. Mary Catherine Smoke. Lauren Sabotic, magna cum laude. Stephen Sabotic. Olive Somersall. Alex Soto. Janelle Stanley. Todd Brandon Steidel. Megan Stoltz. Lakeisha Street. Kristen Svercek. Nolan Swick. Brandon Taylor. Brent Taylor. Johnny Thibodeau. Brian Thibodeau. Blandon Jamal Thomas. Brandon Lee Thomas. Dexter Herbert Thomas. Christopher Thompson. Joshua Thorson. Rory Jamal Tillis. Samuel Tuck. Jared Tucker. Elioth Valencia. Tiffany Valerie. Letitia Valerio. Karina Vargas. Francis Therese Vasquez. Oswaldo Vasquez. Maria Vera. Jamie Vestal, cum laude. Shelby Vickers. Kevin Victor. Lori Wojtek. Mary Morgan Walker. Brandon Warford, magna cum laude. Charlie Watkins. Ernest Watkins. Tiffany Watson. Matthew Watt. Rachel Lynn Watts. Jennifer Elizabeth Weaver, cum laude. Jessica Wettstein. Robert Wheatfall. Brian White. Millard Whitehead.
Deshaun Williams. Sarah Williams. Michael Paul Willoughby. Steve Wilson. Anya Wilson. Wayne Ray Wise. Suzanne Janelle Wood. Justin Woodall. Brian Woods. Kimberly Ann Wooten. Alicia Renee Worthington. Victoria Lee Zumwalt. Graduates, may our Lord bless you and keep you, each and every one. Graduates, please stand. As a symbol of your graduation, would you please move your tassels from left to right? Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduated class of 2001. Will the audience please remain seated for the benediction and remain seated until the graduates have left the field. The benediction will be led by Miss Tiffany Biasen. Seniors, please remove your hats and tassels.
Please bow your head in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for giving our class this night to celebrate our achievements thus far. We thank you, Lord, for enriching and working miracles in our lives through our families, teachers, and friends. As we go out into the real world, we ask that you continue to bless and inspire us with new faces who are working toward the same goal of glorifying your name. Also give us the patience to respect the differences of others with whom we might not see eye to eye. Lord, we thank you for everything you have given us in life, even if it was discouraging at times, because now we are stronger individuals ready to face the world and ready for whatever you have in store for our future. Although it seems as though we are leaving behind comfort and familiarity, we rejoice because we will always be secure in the palm of your hand. Tonight, we will walk out of the stadium as the first graduating class of the millennium. Lord, we ask for your guidance as we venture into the world as young, independent men and women who will do so many great things. We will aim high by reaching for the stars, and we will make dreams come true, but only with you by our side, Lord, because through you, anything is possible. In your holy name we pray, amen.
Seniors, are you ready? One.